Pop star Billie Eilish has recorded the title track for the new James Bond film, No Time to Die. The US singer, who turned 18 last month, is the youngest artist in history to write and record a theme for the franchise. The song was released at midnight at the same time as a new trailer for the film starring Daniel Craig.
Name?
Bond. James Bond.
We're joined by film and TV composer Andrew Swarbrick. Andrew, what's your verdict?
I really love it. I just thought that with the likes of Hans Zimmer, who always wants to push things forward and do new things, and then Billie Eilish, who probably isn't afraid to break the rules, you always might have thought that could have done something wildly different, but I was really pleased that actually they didn't try and reinvent the wheel, and what they've done is really just feels like an extension to what's come before. It's interesting that The Guardian picked up on the vague hint from Diamonds Are Forever that what I heard was similarities with the more recent songs of having sort of a minor chord with a descending bass line. That's kind of what it stuck out to me. And then, of course, there's the use of the classic minor chord with the major ninth, which is, we just hit it there, which is used at the end, and what I think the track is hugely based on. But I think it's great. I think it's done really well, and I love Billie's voice.
I shall listen to it afresh with notes like that to refer to. It's a great opportunity for a composer, but how big is the pressure for writing a Bond theme, which, of course, is going to be heard by millions and millions of people for years on end?
I can only imagine it, to be honest, because I've not been in that position. But, yeah, I can... It must be pretty immense to sort of have that. I mean, at the age of 18, it's just amazing, really, that she's had that opportunity, and I just think it's brilliant, and I think she's really done a good job, and she's risen to the challenge, and I think it's a great song.
What you're trying to do, I suppose, is create an earworm that doesn't get on people's nerves, aren't you? It sounds like it's a simple tune, but there's a lot of complexity in it.
Yes, that's right. I think it grabs you straight away, and of course they are accessing the original theme, which everyone loves, and it's been with us for 50 years. I think they did well to have hints of that in, and people are going to sort of like it for that reason as well. But I think the lyrics and the melody is really sympathetic to, and sort of has the characteristics of a great Bond theme.
Yeah, you can hear those influences, can't you, that we're familiar with from previous ones. But when you're given a commission, how clear are the people asking you to write a piece of music about what they really want?
Well, that's one of the difficulties. I think you really have to sort of see beyond what might be being said to you, because people try and explain things in musical terms, but that's subjective. And I think the best bet is to really get in the head of the director you're working with and sort of digest what they're trying to do. And then you need to go away and try and capture that in a few notes, you know, and I think that's the key. There's a great quote from Monty Norman, the guy that wrote the original theme, where he said, talking about Bond, he said, "His sexiness, his mystery and ruthlessness, all in a few notes, all there in a few notes." And that's why it's such a great theme. It's just a few notes, it's instantly recognisable, and the story is there in those notes. And I suppose when you're drawing from that, you're starting from a really good place. So that's why I'm really pleased that they haven't reinvented the wheel, that they've done something that really fits in.
He did the groundwork, didn't he, to set everyone else on their way. Andrew Swarbrick, thank you for talking to us.
Cheers.